Autocrafters, your source for Cougar, Falcon, Fairlane, Full-Size, Mustang, Maverick, Pinto, Ford Truck. Contact us at www.autocrafters.com.
Right. So, last week we took the glass out, found out that we had a problem with the original finish being the dark sequoia brown and the window perimeter around the gasket being the gold of unknown origin. So, we went in the course of the last week or so, custom mixed ourselves up a little bit of gold because the stuff that we got from our local paint store, Palmetto, wasn't quite there. So we took some other dark sequoia brown that we had for the interior, mixed the two bases together, and came up with unknown gold. It matches the truck well enough. I'm happy with it. So this week, what we're planning on doing is we're going to go in and actually install the glass in our 72 F100. What I'm going to talk to you about now is the parts that go into this opening around the glass. I've never done one of these windows before. I have done gasketed glasses in Ford Mustangs. I've never done one in a pickup truck with the perimeter trim stuck inside the rubber molding. I'll confess to being a little nervous. But let's go talk parts right now. Okay, so weather strip. This is what we're going to be installing into the 72 F100. We got this from the guys at Autocrafters. It is a very nice piece from Dennis Carpenter. And I wanted to go over a couple of little things that we're going to be doing with this setup that is a little different than what you're going to see from a lot of different people. Even Dennis Carpenter, when they send this out, say that you're supposed to go in and use a string method to put the glass in. And I tend to not do that. I've busted three or four strings trying to get the glass to seat and install. I've gone to a different method, and that is to use trim tools like these that we got from the guys over at our Harbor Freight here in town. And I'll use the ends of these to pick the weather strip out. I will set the bottom edge of it into the channel, and then I will go in and start picking the weather strip around the outside perimeter using these tools to make this happen. I'm not going to say that there's a never and always in any of this. The string method works great for a lot of guys. Tons of folks use it. I find the string method to be incredibly messy when compared to using the trim tools. When I'm doing the string method, the string will invariably get drug in through the gasket sealer that you put on the outside perimeter of the windshield, and thus the mess ensues. And when you're pulling it into the interior of the truck, with the messy string, you're going to get that crap everywhere. It's going to be all over your trim, all over the inside of the truck or the car. So I've kind of gone to this other method because it makes a little bit less mess when you're doing the installation. So the other thing that I'm going to be using is this, and this is the 08509 auto bedding and glazing compound. We have had a viewer pish tosh the use of this product. I'm a little confused because this is exactly what Ford would have used in order to put the windshields in the cars back in the day. Application methods may change a little bit. It may vary on how this stuff goes in, but as far as I'm concerned, this works great. I've had great success using this product for years and years and years. I'm not going to change. So, that being said, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to pull all this aside and I'm going to drag my old glass in here, which I've pulled off the truck already, and show you how to dismantle that and get the chrome trim off of it, and then show you how to put this on your glass, put the chrome trim on this, and then get all of that to go inside of your truck. At least that's my theory at this point. All right, I have the glass that was originally in the truck up here on the top of our workbench and slash toolbox, and I don't know if this is an original install or not. I don't know if they replaced the glass and went back in and did this, but what I want to do is, because I am going to be using a different glass setup on this, I'm actually using a glass that does not have the button for the rear view mirror. It's a 67 style glass, but what I want to do is to take a measurement from the bottom of that, and on here it comes out to 4 3/4 inch from the bottom of here to the edge of the glass. So for centering the glass, it's not that big of a deal because there's actually a center line on the molding here that you can find whenever you get everything installed and the clip in the right spot. Now our clip's a little off center on here, so it's not going to actually be right on spot. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to basically take this off and just roll it out of position so that I can get the metal off of the weather strip. I'm just going to do that all the way around. I'm going to take this original weather strip off. Anyway, into the night with that. All right, there's a bit of housekeeping I wanted to go into with this piece of glass right here. This is an original Ford car light windshield, probably the original glass for the truck. And there is a difference between this glass and most of the aftermarket glass that you're going to get today. Most of the stuff that you buy aftermarket right now is going to be a thinner glass. It's going to be around 3/32 deep, whereas this stuff is 5/32 deep, and you're going to see a difference in how these two glasses seat. Now, I don't know if that's going to make a real difference in anything, but possibly the windshield weather strip sitting tight against the glass itself, because quite frankly, that could be an issue here. I'm the one that bought the glass. I didn't get original car light because car light was just more expensive than I wanted to spend in a driver truck. Were I going in and doing something that was a very high-end build, like putting a Crown Vic front end in it and a Coyote engine in the front, I would probably go in and buy the original style glass if it's still available in the correct thickness. I don't even know if the car light stuff is as thick as the aftermarket glass that I've got down there on the floor. So, that being said, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go outside and I'm going to clean up our chrome trim here and get it back to a decent shape. I am not going to polish this outside of the truck. I'll polish it when we get the truck put back together because it'll just be easier to take care of. Rather do that than have to do anything else. And besides, like I said before, it's a driver truck and I'm not going to be spending a lot of time on that. I'll use some autosol on it, bada bing, bada boom, I'll be done with it. So, without further ado, I'm gonna swipe all this stuff off the table. So much cleaning to do. I'm a driver. All right, now what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna take the button off of here. You can buy the glass with the button in place, but I'm trying to save a little money, right? So I don't get the button. I'm probably gonna end up spending just about as much time and money because I'm gonna have to go buy some glue to put this on here with. Anyway, I talked myself into a glass without it. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put my safety glasses on because I am gonna be heating this glass up. I've got a flat razor that I'm gonna try to knock this thing down with if I can after I get this heated up. I do not know if this is all gonna work. I've been told you can do this by somewhat nefarious and unreliable sources. I'm going to lay it down a little bit here. I just broke that. I'm going to try using a screwdriver to get it off. Use a little flat blade. Remember, I'm not worried about the glass so much as I am about the hot button. And I'll put that bad boy back in the glass. I could set the new glass on top of the old glass and find my position. I don't want to do that because I'm scared I'll scratch the new glass putting it up here with all the dirt and schmutz that this glass has on it. So that was the next best thing, and I am not going to touch that right now. So that done, I'm going to pull this out of the way and put the new glass up here after I clean it off and install the weather strip. All right, what I'm gonna do now is finish up the bedding and glazing compound on the inside edge of the weather strip. This edge right in here is where your window trim runs. This right here is where the glass sits. I've already got a little bit of the bedding and glazing compound up on this end over here. And what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna put a whole perimeter all the way around. I've already done most of the rest of this. I'm just gonna finish it up and just show you kind of how we do this. Stick that down in there. You run it along. All the way around the windshield. finish this up because really it's just doing the same thing all the way down the windshield. Make sure your corners are good, make sure you got plenty in there, and it should be good to go. All right, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to set the center of this to kind of just show you how to do it. You pinch it open like that, and it'll allow you to do it. You'll probably need to go from the edges though, get the seat. This one usually isn't as big a problem as the side panels. Your bigger problem with this one is going to be to keep it staying where it needs to be while you're putting all the chrome trim back on. The bedding and glazing will also help this stuff stay in position as well, just a little bit. May have to get my trim tool that I used on the other end down there to get this in the seat. I'm just going along and pressuring this into position a little bit. Having a little bit of a problem down here at the top. This is not going to stay in its place like the rest of the glass has done. Everything else is sitting really nice. This one is just a little bit less friendly to staying seated. And I don't know if it's because it's not seated on the glass correctly or not, but it feels like it's seated okay. Okay, now I'm gonna take these off. I'm gonna roll the glass over to do our trim work. I'm gonna have to lay the glass this way. This will also let me check from position of this on here. Okay. Get the trim. All right, I'm stopping the video right here because this is the next best place to stop it. From here on out, it gets really picky and finicky for putting the chrome trim on and then installing the glass. And I really want to devote a lot of time to installing that glass to really give you a sense of exactly how much work goes into putting one of these glasses in an F100. If I were a professional installer who did this every day, I would probably be able to do this much, much quicker. But I am really, really afraid of breaking glass. I don't want to spend another $100, so I'm taking my time, which is what you would have to do. I am not a professional, nor do I pretend to be one in any of this stuff, so I want you to understand that when you're watching this video today and next week. This is just an enthusiast putting the glass in his truck because he wanted to. Yes, I could have called the professionals and had one of them come out and put the glass in for me. What's the fun in that? Anyway, that's our episode for this week, folks. We'll look forward to seeing you on down the road.